great is thy faithfulness, O God, my Father. There is no shadow of turning with thee. Thou changest not thy compassions
that fail not.
As thou hast been before ever with me, great is thy faithfulness. Great is thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, thy hand hath provided. Great is thy faithfulness, Lord, unto
springtime and harvest, sun, moon, and stars in their courses above, join with all nature in manifold witness to thy great faithfulness, mercy, and love.
Good morning, Brother Dale. God bless you this morning. Good to see you. Good morning, Miss Bonnie. How are you? Great is thy faithfulness. For tomorrow,
blessings mine with 10,000 beside.
Great is thy faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness. Great is thy faithfulness, Lord. Provided. Yes.
Great is thy faithfulness.
Great is thy faithfulness, Lord, unto me. Greetings in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. We welcome you to the Restoration Church Ministries. I'm Pastor Gerald Adams. It's an honor, a privilege, and a pleasure to be with you on today to share in this time of fellowship and God's and the study of God's Word. We thank God for each and every one of you tuning in today. We thank God for you. And you. We bless the Lord for all that he has done, his manifold blessings to us, for us waking up this morning, clothing our right minds, oh God, with a reasonable portion of our health and strength. We thank God for you all today, and we bless God for you. Today, we're not going to belabor the hour. God has given us a beautiful day, which we want to enjoy. Even though it's raining outside, it's still considered a beautiful day, because if we didn't have rain, the grass wouldn't grow. If we didn't have rain, the beautiful flowers that the ladies like to receive and men like to give, wouldn't grow. So we thank God for his rain today on the earth. We thank God for you, you again, and you. Our scripture text today is coming from 1 Corinthians, the 10th chapter, verses 11 through 13. 1 Corinthians, the 10th chapter, verses 11 through 13. But as we always do, we want to go before the Lord in prayer, invoke his presence, so that anything that we do, he will be a part of it. And we thank God again for you. So let us bow our heads in the word of prayer, and then we will go forth with the word for today. Father, in the name of your son, Jesus, we give you glory, we give you honor, we give you praise for this day. Oh God, that you have given us, we thank you for life. We thank you for health. We thank you for strength, God. We thank you, oh God, for being God all by yourself. And we thank you for this opportunity that you have given this day, oh God. We thank you for being in the land of the living, oh God. We thank you again, oh God, for blessing and keeping us, providing for us, oh God. We thank you for the people, oh God, that have found it not robbery to be on the line live this morning with us, oh God. And we take their time, oh God, in consideration, God. So bless them, oh God, as they spend their time with us today. Send out a special blessing, oh God, to the hearers of this word, but not only hearers, but doers of the word, that they might trust you, believe you, oh God, that you are who you said you are. We give you glory, honor, and praise in the mighty, matchless name of your dear son, Jesus, and we say amen. Amen, amen, amen. Again, we thank God for you, you, and you being with us on today. God bless each and every one of you. Our scripture text today is coming from 1 Corinthians, the 10th chapter, verses 11 through 13. 1 Corinthians, the 10th chapter, verses 11 through 13. And the word of the Lord reads on this wise. God bless each and every one of you that's on the line this morning in the name of the Lord. Now all these things happen unto them for examples. And they are written for our admonition, upon whom the ends of the world are come. Wherefore, let him that thinketh he standeth take heed lest he fall. There hath no temptation taken you, but such is common to man. But God is faithful. Can anybody say that today? God is faithful, who will not suffer you to be tempted above that you are able, but will with the temptation also make a way to escape, that ye may be able to bear it. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading of his word. May he sanctify it deep down within our hearts. I want to speak to you today, right here from verse number 13. God is faithful. So I want to speak to you today from just a thought. The thought of the faithful God. The faithful God. The faithful God. With the current events in the world today, it can be hard, it can be difficult, not just to see how we can move forward in life, but the reason to even get up out of our beds in the mornings. In our minds, you know, we formulate questions. When we go through things in life, we formulate these questions in our minds about how or why God allowed, or why would he allow certain things to happen in this world and take place. What are you talking about, Pastor Adams? I'm talking about things like with the loss of over 6 million, not 600, not 6,000, not even 600,000, 6 million lives to COVID, tornadoes and hurricanes, wiping out entire communities, murders, and crime taking over our cities. It could be hard, praise the name of our God, for the average individual to trust that God is being faithful. It could be hard for us to put trust and faith in the God of our salvation, when we see all of these things taking place around us, when we see current events of nations attacking other nations, when we see, hallelujah, that because of one man, hallelujah, thousands of people, hundreds of thousands of people are at war. Praise the name of our God. And it could be hard for the average person to believe or to put faith in the fact that God is faithful. The overwhelming cares and vicissitudes of life causes many to doubt whether God even cares about what is happening to them. Oh, praise the name of our God. We see people dying all around us every day. We see people suffering. We see people, hallelujah, sick in their bodies. And we wonder, hallelujah, does God even care? Is God even paying attention? I understand that there are moments, hallelujah, where we grow, hallelujah, we grow weary, we grow empty, we grow tired as we wait on God, as we wait for God to do, hallelujah, what he's going to do in our lives, how he's going to bless us, how he's going to carry us through. And in all the challenging moments of life, hallelujah, that we face in life, we need to be reminded sometimes of some of the great truths that affirm God's faithful nature. In other words, his faithfulness is who he is. Hallelujah. We have to understand that his faithfulness is connected to his character. Oh God, I praise you. He cannot get outside of himself. He will not, the Bible says, deny himself. So his faithfulness is a part of and connected to his character. But before I go and I get too far gone in this message today, I want you to allow me just a brief moment to identify and define the meaning of faithfulness. When you think about faithfulness, you must think of it as being defined as steadfast in, hallelujah, affection, or in other words, to remain loyal, true, and devoted, or otherwise being trustworthy. I'm going to say that again. It is defined as steadfast in affection. Oh, praise the name of our God. It is remaining true, loyal, devoted, or otherwise being trustworthy. No matter what you're facing today, please hear me, God. Please hear me, y'all. No matter what you're facing today, no matter the trials or tribulation of life, I came by here to encourage each and every one of you today that God is devoted to you. Hear me good now. If you don't take anything else from this message today, I want you to take the fact and I want you to hide it in your heart that God is devoted to me. Oh, praise the name of our God. Despite how you may feel at this time, oh, praise the name, and how we may perceive circumstances through our limited understanding and self-focused tendencies, God is altogether good. He is altogether wise. He's altogether sovereign and altogether powerful. Therefore, we can indeed trust him because he is faithful, hallelujah, in all things. He is faithful at all times. God's faithfulness is his reliability in doing what he has promised. In other words, we can rely on God to do exactly what he said he would do. We can rely on God, hallelujah, even when we are faithless, God is still faithful. Therefore, God's faithfulness means that he is completely worthy of our faith, worthy, hallelujah, and of our praise. And because God is faithful and fulfills all of his promises to his people, our response should always be, hallelujah, that of Proverbs 3:5-6, that tells us to trust in the Lord with all of our hearts. and lean not to our own understanding, but in all of our ways we must acknowledge him. And the Bible says he will direct our path. God's word shines forth, hallelujah, the faithfulness of God as most clearly manifested in person of the works of Jesus Christ. In other words, in Christ, we see God's faithfulness put to the full display. Oh, God, hallelujah. When you see Jesus, you see the faithfulness of God on full display. In other words, God takes the time and he takes a tapestry and he uses Jesus to paint the picture of his faithfulness to all humanity. All the promises of the Old Testament are ultimately, hallelujah, fulfilled in Jesus Christ. 2 Corinthians, praise the name of our God, 1:20 tells us, for all things are all the promises of God in him are yea, and in him amen, unto the glory of God by us. What is he saying here? That is why it is through him, through Jesus I'm talking about, that we utter our amens to God for his glory. Oh God, we utter our praises to him for his honor. We utter our amens to him for his praise. When our faith in God is tested by sadness, difficulties, and dark seasons in life, we do well to consider the scriptures. We do well to consider the word of God. What are you talking about, Pastor Adams? Well, then just go to the word of God and let's look at what the word says in Isaiah 50:10, that it tells us who is among you that fear the Lord, that obeys the voice of his servant, that walks in darkness and has no light. It says, it goes on to say, let him trust in the name of the Lord and rely on his God. In times of suffering and trials, we must hold firm to the faithfulness of God, trusting and believing in the promise that he gave us in Romans 8:28. When he says to us that, and we know, and Paul states to us that, and we know that all things work together for the good of them that love God and to them who are called according to his purpose. Follow me here. I just want you all to just follow me here for a second, because Romans 8:28 goes deeper, hallelujah, than just sprouting it off or memorizing this thing. It says, and we know that all things work together for what? For good. Just follow me here. Israel, praise the name of our God, would forget the faithfulness of their God. They would forget how faithful God had been to them. He brought them out of Egypt by performing amazing miracles before them. But they would complain when they're faced by a Red Sea and they're faced with Pharaoh, hallelujah, and his chariots at their back. Oh, praise the name of our God. They would forget the faithfulness of God. Hallelujah. On how, hallelujah, he gave them manna from heaven to eat, praise the name of our God. But they would complain, hallelujah, because they didn't know what it was. Oh God, they would forget the faithfulness of God, hallelujah, when he gave them water to drink, praise the name of our God, hallelujah, and laws to govern them. But then they turn around and complain and want to go back. Hallelujah, back into, hallelujah, the thing that they came out of, hallelujah. And in our text today, Paul admonishes us, hallelujah, that we, hallelujah, not fall into the same kind of behavior that Israel fall into, hallelujah. It says here that it was, that the things that they went through is for examples unto us. It is written for our admonition. In other words, Paul says, take what they, the areas in which they failed at, and we should use them as examples where we should not fail. In other words, Paul is saying to us today that we should hide, hallelujah, these things in our hearts, that we might not sin against the Lord. Israel fell into what I'm going to call today, what good place of life. They fell into what good is it place of life. Praise the name of our God. Hallelujah. When suffering came, hallelujah, they would say, what good, hallelujah, is it? What good is freedom if we must starve to death? What good is life if we must die of dehydration? Hallelujah. And some of us find ourselves caught in, hallelujah, the what good of life is it in life that we find ourselves in? What good is it, hallelujah, we find ourselves saying, what good is it when my body is racked with pain? What good is it when people talk about me and scandalize my name? What good is it when I must bury the very ones that I love, that God told me, hallelujah, hallelujah, that he would bless, hallelujah, and then we're losing our loved ones. What good is life when my bank account, hallelujah, saying I only have $100, but when I go to the mailbox, praise the name of our God, the bills that comes out of them is valued at over $2,000. Mm-hmm. What good is it? I am so glad you ask. Hallelujah. What good is life? I'm so glad you asked. Pastor Adams came by today to encourage your heart. Hallelujah. That all we have to do is to find out what is good, or what good is it, is to go to God's word. Hallelujah. When we find in God's word, we can find the answers to our question. We can find the answer to what good is it in his word. You go to Romans 5, 3 through 5. The Bible tells us, hallelujah, it says, but we glory in what? Tribulation. Knowing that tribulation work what? Patience. And patience experience, and experience it works hope. And the hope make, hallelujah, make us not ashamed, because the love of God is shed abroad in our hearts by the Holy Ghost, which is given unto us. I came by to encourage somebody today that even now that you might be going through, even now, hallelujah, that you might feel, hallelujah, that you might be struggling right now, I came by to encourage your hearts today that God is, he's working it out for your good. What good is life? I came by and to tell you what good it is. Hallelujah. Romans 8, 29 through 30. The Bible tells us, for whom he did foreknew, he also did predestinated to be conformed to the image of his son, that he might be the firstborn among many brethren. Here we go. Moreover, whom he did predestinated, them he also called, and whom he called, them he also justified, and whom he justified, them he also glorified. Oh God, I praise you. What good is it? God sent me to tell you that God says that it is for the good of my people. What good is it? It's for the good of my purpose. What good is it? It's for the good of my promise. I'm going to say it again, so each and every one of you can get it today. When you ask the question, God, what good is it? God answers back to each and every one of us today, and he says that it is good for my people. It is good for my purpose. It is good for my promises. Oh, so we must then find ourselves trusting in the God of our salvation, because he is the faithful God. He is the God that we can call on in the middle of the night. He is the God that we can call on when all hell start breaking loose in our lives. He is the God that we can call on that will stick closer than a brother, than a mother, than a father, than a sister. He is a God that is so faithful that we can put our trust in him. So when you place your trust in the faithful God, there are three things I want to leave you with that you can know without a shadow of a doubt. When you place your faith and trust in the faithful God, the first thing that you can know is that God is faithful to His purpose and His plans. He is faithful to His purpose and His plan. What God plans, He accomplishes. What He starts, He also finishes. According to Ephesians 1:11, He says it this way: He works all things. According to the counsel of His will, from the creation of the cosmos to the banks of the ocean and seas, God plans and purpose are accomplished. From the grass growing to the air we breathe, God's plans and God's purpose are accomplished. From your very birth to the day of your death, God's plans and God's purpose will be accomplished. There is nothing that gets by God. There is nothing that slides past Him. No aspects of our lives that He cannot handle. What are you saying, Pastor Adams? You have to only leave it to God. You don't have to trust in your own thoughts. You don't have to believe your own thoughts and admonitions about your life. You don't believe me? I promise you that God His faithfulness is faithful to His plans and His purpose. You don't believe me? Let's go to the Word. Oh God, the Word testifies in Jeremiah 29 and verse 11. For I know the thoughts I think towards you, He says the Lord, thoughts of peace and not of evil, to give you an expected end. What are you saying, Pastor Adams? I'm trying to tell you that God's plans and purpose don't depend on you, but it depends on His faithfulness. His faithfulness to you. His faithfulness to you. When God is faithful, when the faithful God is moving in your life and you place your trust in Him, you can know with a surety that God is faithful not only to His plans and His purpose, but He is faithful to His people. The faithfulness of God is the God in whom you can put your trust. God is trustworthy, in other words. You can trust Him, and you can always put your confidence in the God, in the faithful God. He will never leave you. He will never forsake you. He will never leave or let you down. He was faithful. Oh God, I praise you. When I think of the goodness of Jesus and all that He's done for me, I got to give Him praise because He's been faithful to everything. Hallelujah. To me. What you talking about? I just got to think about my lying down last night. Oh God, I praise you. He was faithful in in our laying down last night. He was faithful in our getting up this morning. He was faithful with food on our tables. He is faithful. I got clothes on my back. He is faithful. Where is he? It's heat when it's cold. And he is faithful that I have air conditioned when it's hot. How many of us can relate and echo the psalmist in Psalm 37 and verse 25 when he says with the assurity, I've been young and now I'm old, but yet have I've seen the righteous, I've not seen the righteous forsaken, nor his seed begging bread. He is faithful. He's the faithful one. He's the faithful God. Faithful when we are tempted. Hallelujah. 1 Corinthians 10 and 13. Our scripture says there is no temptation that's taken you, but that such as is common to man. But God is. He is faithful. Who will not suffer you to be tempted above you are able, but will with the temptation also make a way to escape that ye may be able to bear it. He is faithful when we are tempted. He is faithful when we are weak. You don't believe me? Let's go to 2 Thessalonians 3 and 3. The Bible says, but the Lord, he is faithful, who shall establish you and keep you from evil. He is faithful in your weakness. He is faithful when you're tempted. He is faithful when you suffer. 1 Peter 4 and 19. Wherefore, let them that suffer according to the will of God commit the keeping of their souls to him in well-doing. Why? Because as unto the faithful creator, he is faithful in your suffering. He is faithful even when you sin. You don't believe me? There's Bible for that one too. God is faithful in our times of sin. 1 John 1 and 9. If we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us of our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. He is faithful when we sin. He is faithful when we suffer. He is faithful when we are weak. And he's faithful to the call that's on your life. 1 Thessalonians 5 and 23 through 24. The Bible says, and the very God of peace sanctify you wholly. And I pray, God, your Holy Spirit, or the whole, your whole spirit and soul and body be preserved blameless unto the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. Faithful is he that calleth you, who also will do it. In other words, God is faithful to you, to the call on your life. When you find yourself in sin, when you find yourself suffering, when you find yourself at your weakest point, And when you find yourself tempted in life, God is the faithful God. Oh God, I praise you. When you find, hallelujah, you trusting in the faithful God, he is faithful to his plans and his purpose. He is faithful to all of his people. And the last one, before I get on out of your way, that he is faithful even to his promises. The faithfulness of our God replaces anxiety with peace. What are you talking about? Just go to Philippians 4 through 7. And the Bible says, rejoice in the Lord always. And again, I say, rejoice. Drop down to verse 7. And it says this way. And the peace of God, which passes all understanding, shall keep your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus. The faithful God will replace your anxiety with peace. The faithfulness of God replaces a doubt with confidence. You don't believe me? I got Bible for you. 1 Peter 4:19. Wherefore, let them that suffer according to the will of God commit the keeping of their souls to him and well-doing as unto the faithful God. In other words, when I place my faith in God, we can then put our energy into everything that God wants us to pursue. Pursue his righteousness. Pursue his holiness. Pursue the ministering of God's amazing grace to everyone we meet. He is the faithful God. If that's not enough word for you, go to 1 John 5:14 to 15. In the Bible saying, that not only is God faithful, but he replaces your doubts with confidence. 1 John 5:14 to 15. And this is the confidence that we have in him, that if we ask anything according to his will, he hears each and every one of us. And if we know that he hears us, whatsoever we ask, we know that we have the petitions that we desire. Be encouraged today. Be encouraged today that God is working on your behalf. Be encouraged today that God has you as the apple of his eye. Oh God, be encouraged today to, oh God, I praise you, that you can trust him, that he will never leave you nor forsake you. You can serve the faithful God, somebody, anybody, everybody. Give God, the faithful God, oh wonderful, the highest, a remarkable praise right where you are. God, he is faithful to keep that what you commit unto him. I'm talking about God, the one who got you up. Oh God out of bed this morning. I'm saying, God, that give you ankle strength when you stood up on your two feet today. I'm talking about God that gave you the courage to trust him. The God that spoke the cosmos into existence. Who is like? I said, who is like the faithful God, the one who redeems from the hand of the enemy, one who has all power in his hands? Who is like the faithful God that makes a way out of no way? Who is like our faithful God that heals the sick and redeems the broken? Who is like the faithful God that can break every addiction? Who is like the faithful God that will bless you when you need him to? Who is like the faithful God that can go from North Carolina all the way to Ukraine and bless his people? Who is like the God, a faithful God, that will not allow all the situations and trials of life to defeat you? The Bible tells us in his word to fret not yourself for evildoers. Oh God, I praise you for in due season the Lord will hallelujah make them your footstools. The Bible tells us that God will make a way for you. God will bless you in your going out and your coming in. And when he bless you, do like the psalmist in Psalm 89 that screams from the top of his lungs, I will sing of the mercies of the Lord forever. With my mouth will I make unto him thy faithfulness to all generations. You can sing just like the psalmist that thy seed will be established forever and built up your throne because of your faithfulness. In verse 5, he says it this way, and the heavens shall praise thy wonders, O Lord. Why? Because of thy, your faithfulness is always towards your saints. He is the faithful God, the one who makes a way, the one who is strong and mighty. He's mighty in battle. The Bible says, O Lord of hosts, who is strong, oh God, it's because your faithfulness is round about thee. Oh God, I praise you. It's all about the faithfulness of the faithful one. Jesus says it, even himself, and the word of God, when he says, God says it this way, but my faithfulness and my mercy shall be with you, and in my name shall his horn be exalted. In other words, God will exalt you above measure. God will Be faithful to you because he is the faithful. He's faithful. The faithful. Get it in your spirit. He's faithful when I'm sick. He's faithful when I'm not well. He's faithful when I'm broke. He's faithful when I need. He's faithful when I cry out. He's faithful in the midnight hour. He's faithful in the doctor's office. He's faithful in the courtroom. He is faithful when we need him because he is faithful. He's faithful. He is the faithful God. Hallelujah. He is the faithful God. Hallelujah. You can get no more faith than him giving up his own life for you, for me. Hallelujah. You can get no more faithful, hallelujah, than making sure that you make a way, that he made a way, hallelujah, that we might not be condemned to damnation, to hell. Hallelujah. He made a way. He is so faithful that he makes a way that you eat every day. He makes a way. He is so faithful. You may not want to eat Roman noodles, but you ate. That means he's faithful. Hallelujah. You may not have the best sodas or pops or however you want to call it, lemonades. You may have to only drink water, but he is faithful that you have something to drink. You may not have $1 million, but if your bills are paid, he's faithful. And even when your bills aren't paid, he's still faithful, because you still have a roof over your head, your lights are still on, if you have gas, that's still on, water's running in your faucets. He's faithful. God bless each and every one of you. I want you all to go away today knowing that you are serving a faithful God. We know what is going on in this world. Mm-hmm. We know because of one man, tens of thousands of people are displaced, if not hundreds of thousands, all because he has to have his way. But be encouraged today. There is a faithful God that sits high, looks low, and he operates in the affairs of men. God is faithful. No matter what you're facing today, saints, he is the faithful God. Father, in the name of your son, Jesus, we bless you today, oh God, because you are God all by yourself. We thank you today, God, because we know for without a shadow of a doubt, oh God, that you are faithful. We thank you, God, for your blessing us, keeping us. God, for that one right now, that man, that woman, that boy, that girl that's hearing my voice right now, that are in doubt, God, of your faithfulness, prove it to them today. Turn their doubt into confidence today. God, prove it to them today. Replace their anxiety with peace. God, prove it to them today. Oh, God, as only you can. Father, heal their precious body right now In the name of Jesus, that pain that's racking their body, remove it now by the power of your Spirit. Father, we thank you, according to your word, O God, that you've made a way for us. O God, for each and every one of us, O God, that would turn to you. O God, we thank you today that you are faithful. O God, for those that are sinners, and they know they are sinners, Lord, give them a heart of repentance that they might turn to you. For those that are in backslidden states, O God, we pray today, O God, that they would find, O God, the word of God in 1 John that tells them if they confess their sins, you are faithful and just to forgive us of our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Lord, today, in the name of Jesus, heal your people. Bless your people. God, we pray right now for nations that are fighting against nations, oh God, that you would bring peace upon the earth. God, this world needs your help now. This earth is sick, oh God. Sick, oh God, with a pandemic, oh God. Sick, oh God, with sin. Sick with murders, God. Sick with, hallelujah, every kind of schisms and isms, God. Sexism, racism, oh God. In the name of Jesus, the land is sick. And we know the only remedy is you, God. Your salvation, your Jesus, your blood, Jesus. So heal the land, God, we pray. In the name of Jesus Christ. Heal your people under the sound of my voice right now. Oh God, those that are in pain right now, heal that pain right now. God, those that need, oh God, a release, oh God, release them right now. God, those that are crying out, oh God, because they are addicted to something or some substance, God. Oh God, break every chain by the power of your presence. Father, we thank you and we praise you today. Bless your people, oh God, I pray. Bless them and make them a blessing, oh God, because you are the faithful God who has promised. And we hold on to the promises, the purposes, oh God, that you have and the call that you have on our lives. We give you glory, honor, and praise for it now. In Jesus' name, we bless you and we say thank God and amen. Well, God bless each and every one of you. I thank the Lord for you being here. I thank the Lord for your time. I take it not, hallelujah, likely that you spent your time with us. We thank you for connecting with the Restoration Church Ministries. We thank you for, hallelujah, being a part of the ministry. And you can always stay connected to everything that we're doing in the ministry. There are several ways that you can do that. Praise the name of our God. We on Sunday mornings, we have Sunday school at 10 a.m. The information is always on Facebook where you can join and you can be a part of the Sunday school Bible lessons. On Sunday morning, we have 11 a.m. worship. Praise the name of our God. On Tuesday and Thursdays, we have corporate prayer. If you have a prayer request, please, you can place it in the chat. Or you, if it's of a private nature, you can send it to the inbox, The Restoration Church Ministries here on Facebook, or you can send it to me at Gerald Adams on Facebook. And we will take those prayer requests and we will label before the Lord in prayer on your behalf. On Wednesday evenings, we have Bible study at 7:30. That information, again, we meet on Google's Meet, where you can join and be a part of the discussion. If you have any questions about anything that's in the message on Sunday that you may want to ask, you can join us there on Wednesday and we will be glad, hallelujah, to explain and go through God's word with you. God bless each and every one of you is my prayer. We thank God for you, you and you, especially those that sow seeds and give to the ministry so that you can strengthen our hands to do what God has called us to do, to be a blessing in our community. Oh God, we thank you, each and every one of you that give to this ministry. And if you would like to be a blessing, there are several ways you can do so. You can send a gift to The Restoration Church Ministries, P.O. Box 152 in Indian Trail, North Carolina, 28079. That's P.O. Box 152 in Indian Trail, North Carolina, 28079. Or you can give electronically. You can give, if you have the Givelify app, you can go to Givelify, go to The Restoration Church Ministries. You will see the logo of the church, which is behind me, and you will see the picture of Lady Adams and myself, and you will know that you're giving in the right place. Or you can go to the church's Cash app. which is the $TRC Ministry. That's $TRC Ministry. And we thank God for everything that you give. We thank you for your liberality and all that you give to the ministry. But most of all, we thank God for you being a part and being here with us, sharing in this time of fellowship. I love you all with the love of the Lord. God bless you. May heaven smile upon you and keep you is my prayer. You are always welcome here at the Restoration Church Ministries, where the blood of Jesus covers every gray area of life. This has been Pastor Gerald Adams with the Restoration Church Ministries. God bless you and keep you. I love you with the love of the Lord, and there is nothing that you can do about it. God bless you and have a great day. In Jesus' name, have a great day.